Yeah. So today's first presentation will be about how to start your game dev career. So how many people here don't work on games yet and want to start? Okay, quite a few. Great, great. So this talk will be for you. So hi, I'm Patryk Gałach. I'm making games for more than 5.5 years already. Mostly this time I spent in Poland, from where I came from. I'm also running Lublin GameDev Foundation back in Lublin. And I'm also head of game department at Netins Software, and this is company that brings me here. So what's the agenda for today? So the first one, of course, difference between IT and game dev, because there are some similarities that you might consider, go either way. And how life of game developer look like. Of course, how to not be your average person that want to go with this game dev dream. And of course, where to start looking for game dev jobs. So first, IT or game dev, which one should I choose? Well, I will go with second options, mainly because I'm afraid of corporate IT. So of course, with IT, you know, I imagine that you have like dress all those suits, stay all the time in front of your computer, do things that other people tell you to do. And I don't really like that. I like to have this little freedom that game dev is giving you. And of course, you will meet so many crazy people in game dev that I don't even consider going into IT. That's my opinion. So you, of course, you don't need to be a programmer to make games. I think we are moved from those times, and right now everyone can make games. There are tools that don't require programming skills at all, and sometimes you just need to connect some blocks and game will work. Of course, besides programmers, there are so many game opportunities, so you can be game designer, sound designer, making models, concept art, so many things that I can't even name it. But probably if you came from a little weird background, probably there is some opportunity to work in game dev, nonetheless. So what connect all those people working in game industry? So of course, first, passion. You have to be passionate about games. Because other way, people will see that this game doesn't feel right, because I feel that the guy who made this game was forced to do that. And players will feel that. And so you really have to have a passion for making games, and of course playing, because you will learn so much by playing other games. Of course, dreams. Everyone to make games. I want to make my game so great that it will get award for the best game of the year. This is also my goal. So maybe someday, maybe. Of course, working on a game, you have to establish common goal with your teammates. So you will follow the same dream to make the same game. Sometimes this is a problem, especially on the beginning, because so many people will throw new ideas to your game, and at some point you will like have like this weird thing and that is not connected to each other. So you have to have common goals and try to achieve them. So what's being game developer look like? So of course, you will imagine being developer will be like being a god. I can create everything I can make like on the flip of a switch instantly. Well, it's not like that. I hoped it will be someday, but not at this point. Sometimes you have so much fun adding those little things, and sometimes there are people that, oh my god, I just implement the doors opening by itself as player approach them, and people will go crazy and they will enjoy that, because it's so fun to see those things come to reality and live. And there is also this other side. I love this picture. I don't know how many of you know The Witcher series. Anyone? Oh, great! Whoa! Amazing! So, you probably didn't hear about the first and second game, but the third one, it's get to you. And there is this true, I don't know if you know this term, crunch time, but basically this is a point where you are coming to the release of the game, and there is so much more to do that you cannot squeeze in your normal work time, if there's something like that exists in game dev. So probably you will have to spend additional hours during the week and sometimes even weekends to deliver product in this within this deadline and release game. But you have to remember that, come on, we are making entertainment. We should bring joy to players and of course, Oops. Come on. I broke it. Oh. Yeah, so you should bring joy to players and of course you should bring some kind of joy to yourself because come on, we can't like be that boring. We are making games, we should have fun doing that. And of course this is great because making games is something so interesting that you all came up with so many weird problems that you will you should have find solution, but yeah, sometimes it doesn't work. But why we have those patch that you can later apply. So, of course, with making games, there is some risk, actually pretty big. Right now, I'm not sure about statistics, but last year there was like 7,000 game released on Steam only. And I can even count how many games are released on mobile every day. Those are probably hundreds. And you have to you have to know that making games is not something easy. And as I said, this is also some kind of risk trying to release games. Sometimes, well, this is a good example. You probably know Angry Birds. And the story of Rovio is that they start making games back in 2000s, I think, three or something. They create so many games, but none of them succeed, and they almost file for bankruptcy. So they decided to, okay, let's make this last game. And they came up with Angry Birds. So, you know, sometimes risk pays off, but I don't know how many stories are going in different direction, but you have to know that sometimes sometimes things don't pay off. So how to not be an average person that want to get to game industry? Because this is our dream. So first things first, you have to start doing things to show that you are really passionate about making games and you want really to get to the game industry. So I have a few ideas for you. So those are really simple ones. So you can get paper, pencil, start drawing your ideas, start describing them. And this is great exercise for your game designer skills. This is great. And remember, at the beginning, don't overcomplicate games. Try to make those simple ones. Of course, this is the only time I will say that cloning other games is a good idea. And only because you can learn so much by cloning other games. Because on the beginning, you won't have any idea how games works. And seeing how other people will make them will give you so much knowledge. And not only about programming, but also with designing and making some kind of effects. Because you will have to clone them. And, you know, cloning one-to-one, it's not good idea, but try to add some little tweaks to it. Third option, maybe you will get some assignment from your school, and maybe you will see, I can make game based on this assignment, and maybe try to give this to your teacher. And see, you need basically find a way to make more games, because with more games you will learn also more and you will build also your portfolio. Next one, this is the best advice I can give you. We will have next talk about game jams, and attending on game jams is great way to build your portfolio, and you will also see if making games is something that you are interested. If not, you will waste only one weekend of your time. And based on those four, you can take another step. You can join other people working on the projects, so you can apply or try cooperating with people that works on open source games. There's a lot of those for Linux, and you can just Google those projects and try to apply to them. And if you don't feel like joining others, maybe you should try to build your own team. So, and of course, the best way to get noticed is to share your knowledge, and this is why I'm doing this. So, you don't have to be an expert in any field to make presentation. Sometimes all it takes to make some research, and based on your findings, you can tell other people, hey, I just found that making AR games or VR games in Unity is pretty simple. You can just throw a few components on a scene and it works. Wow, amazing. Or you will find something else interesting and you want to share that with other people, so go ahead. There's so much opportunity. You can give speech like this anytime. So, of course, another thing very important, you have to meet people. You have to go outside your basement and start speaking with other people. And you have a few options here. Probably there's a lot more. You will know other conferences here. I don't know many yet. So GDC is a great place to learn about making games, and they have so many lectures there, and they also put those on YouTube. E3, of course, you'll see booth of other games, and you can speak with game makers and see what they are doing, and maybe they will tell you something interesting. Of course, PAX, I heard that on the PAX there is this indie mega booth thing, I think. And so you can go and meet independent developers and ask them how they came up with their game and what they is their experience. Of course, if you're more into computer graphics, go to SIGGRAPH. This is basically the newest high-tech edge things related to computer graphics that there can be. So if you are really nerd about those things, go there. And of course, the best place to meet people is local communities like this one. Come on, join them, attend for events. Of course, IGDA, Unity Meetup, Unreal Meetup, there's probably even more of those in Las Vegas. I think it should be. And probably there are also other communities around US. So whatever you come from, there should be at least something. Or if there is none, like in my case back in Lublin, I have to create my own community. So yeah. And those are just few that are in Poland. And this goat one is Lublin GameDev. Ooh. So after every event or meetup, there is of course some time to network with other people. Of course, it's if there is a beer, then even better. So you can stay today, especially today, and speak with other people, ask them what they are doing, and try, maybe they will tell you something interesting, and maybe those little shortcuts, how to get into game industry. So let's say you've done all those things and no one still reach out to you to hire you or offer internship. There's a few options. I just found those two first, Indeed and Glassdoor. There are some game dev job offering there, so you can apply over there. Of course, you have to have LinkedIn account, so headhunters will find you and offer jobs, of course. And this is really building your confidence that, oh, I'm getting somewhere. It's great. I was so hyped as I received my first like job offer on LinkedIn. I was like, ah, crazy. Of course, if you are using some kind of tool or game engine or whatever else, there is probably forum related to jobs offerings. In Unity case, there is even a separate category for that. Probably for Unreal, there is something similar. If you are using, for example, Photoshop, Blender, whatever else, probably there is also something like that. Of course, attending local events is also a great place because people tend first to go to your local communities to find new talents. So at some point, maybe someone will came here and, hey, I'm looking for, let's say, developer who knows about this, this, and this, or I need an artist who can do this, this, and this. And this is great because you will you can instantly go to this person and start chatting with it. And if you don't want to work with other people, start your own game studio. It's that simple. But remember, at first, don't go with any MMO idea. Please. So, what is your decision? I will leave you with that. So, those are just few things, tricks that you can do to get into game industry. Probably there is so many more opportunities or other ways to do it, but of course you will need nonetheless some kind of portfolio, and this is very important. So, do you have any questions? No? Come on. Okay. Mm-hmm. That's true. There is nothing like overnight success. Yeah, and even I think at some point Square Enix, they almost failed for bankruptcy, and last game that they was about to make, it was Final Fantasy. This is the name. And right now, what the number is? Five there? Yeah, so, yeah, of course. I was afraid a little bit about like, if those differences will be too big, but I just tried, okay, let's go with it. And I think this is something universal, let's say, but come on, this is creative industry. You have to be creative with your work. Any other questions? Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, this is, for me, it's kind of weird because as I came here, definition of gaming means something a little different here because it's related to, yeah, all those casinos over here. Yeah. Yeah, they even have like this whole room with all those computers. I go there one time and I see so many young kids playing the Overwatch and Fortnite. It's amazing. Finally, kids can do something in casinos. Okay, so any other questions? Not okay. Yeah, so speaking about clones, yeah, you know, there's so many games right now that you can't came up with something like crazy innovative right now. Even like Fortnite is clone of other games, so of course PUBG was like first big battle royale game, but there was so many before it. So it's all depends on the execution of the idea, and I think this makes game outstanding. Okay, so let's make a quick break. So we don't, I won't overload you with knowledge.